There are times I get discouraged, trying to carry this heavy load, but I
Yeah. First Kings chapter 19 will be our reading text. The first 18 verses, and I'll read all of those verses, inasmuch as I am not one that is known for reading long texts. First Kings chapter 19. And Ahab told Jezebel all that Elijah had done, and withal how he had slain all the prophets with the sword. Then Jezebel sent a messenger unto Elijah, saying, So let the gods do to me, and more also, if I make not thy life as one of them by tomorrow about this time. And when he saw that, he arose and went for his life, and came to Beersheba, which belongeth to Judah, and left his servant there. But he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness, and came and sat under a juniper tree. And he requested for himself that he might die, and said, It is enough now, O Lord. Take away my life, for I am not better than my fathers. And as he lay and slept under a juniper tree, behold, then an angel touched him and said unto him, Arise and eat. And he looked, and behold, there was a cake baked on the coals and a cruse of water at his head. And he did eat and drink and laid him down again. And the angel of the Lord came again the second time and touched him and said, Arise and eat, because a journey is too great for thee. And he arose and did eat and drink, and went in the strength of that meat 40 days and 40 nights unto Horeb the mount of God. And he came thither unto a cave and lodged there, and behold, the word of the Lord came to him, and he said unto him, Elijah, what doest thou here? And he said, I have been very jealous for the Lord God of hosts, for the children of Israel, for have forsaken thy covenant, thrown down thine altars, and slain thy prophets with the sword. And I, even I only, am left, and they seek my life to take it away. And he said, Go forth and stand upon the mount before the Lord. And behold, the Lord passed by, and a great strong wind rent the mountains, and brake in pieces the rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. And after the wind, an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake. And after the earthquake, a fire. But the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire, a still small voice. And it was so when Elijah heard it that he wrapped his face in his mantle and went out and stood in the entering of the cave. And behold, there came a voice unto him and said, What doest thou here, Elijah? And he said, I have been very jealous for the Lord God of hosts, because the children of Israel have forsaken thy covenant, thrown down thine altars, and slain thy prophet to the sword. And I, even I only, am left, and they seek my life to take it away. And the Lord said unto him, Go, return on thy way to the wilderness of Damascus. And when thou comest, anoint Azazel to be king over Syria, and Jehu the son of Nimshi thou shalt anoint to be king over Israel, and Elisha the son of Shaphat of Abel-Meholah shalt thou anoint to be prophet in my room. And it came to pass that him that escapeth the sword of Azazel shall Jehu slay, and him that escapeth the sword of Jehu shall Elisha slay. But I have left me 7,000 in Israel, all the knees which have not bowed unto Baal, and every mouth which hath not kissed him. Let us pray. Thank you, Lord, for your presence with us. Thank you for the anointing of your Holy Spirit. Thank you because the promise you have made to us, the promises stand sure. You will never leave us nor forsake us. You'll be with us to the end of the earth. And now, Lord, send the anointing of God for preaching this message. May we have listening ears, receptive heart, clarity of thoughts. And may the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in your sight. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. This message is a word from the Lord. Everybody say a word from the Lord. I tell you that at times, as a pastor, and I believe honest preachers will say the same with me, there are times when we do sermonizing. By that I mean you meditate a thought, or you read portions of scripture, and you prepare a message from the reading. But there are other times, which should be all the time, when the Lord God Almighty would just birth in our spirits that which is rhema, that which is present, that which is the mind of God, the precise mind of God for that particular service or setting. This is one such. Message from 1 Kings chapter 19 under the theme, sometimes it feels lonely, but you are not alone. Touch your neighbor and help me to convey this thought to them, please. Tell them sometimes it feels lonely, but you are not alone. Hallelujah. If you believe that, wave your hand and give him praise and glory. Thank you, Jesus. The portion of scripture read points out three outstanding things that happened. And if I had read the entire chapter, you would find another. But we stopped at three outstanding things that happened. And then the discourse, as you read it through, is punctuated with a series of trinities. Things that happen repeatedly at least three times in the text. In the text you will find the trinity of persons, the trinity of times, and the trinity of things. And those are very, very substantive in all of the Holy Scriptures, and not just in this particular text. 1 John chapter 5, verses 7 and 8 says, for there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, which is the Son, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one. And there are three that bear witness in earth, the Spirit, the water, and the blood, and these three agree in one. Can somebody say amen? Amen. Trinity of person, things, and times are can be found all the way through the scriptures. Sun, moon, and star, Jacob, Joseph referred to them in the book of Genesis. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, when referring to the fathers of Israel. Moses, Aaron, and Hur, at that great occurrence there when Moses' hands were kept aloft and Israel prevailed over the enemy as Aaron and Hur stood on his right hand and on his left hand. Wisdom, knowledge, and understanding characterize the life of those who will walk uprightly and make a success of themselves in this life. Peter, James, and John stood with Jesus on the Mount of Transfiguration. Oh, hallelujah. Faith, hope, and charity. These three go hand in hand, but the greatest of these, said the text, is charity. And many, many years ago, whether or not we acknowledge it, Jesus established the World Wide Web, and I borrowed this from Bishop Dr. W. A. Blair, www.com. Wind, waves, and water, Jesus said, dot com. Can you say amen? Trinity is all the way to be found in the scripture. But today I'm not going to be majoring on Trinity. But I just wanted to point out to you that those of us who embrace Jesus' teaching as it relates to the Trinitarian doctrine, that we are standing on solid foundation. Stomp your right foot and say, solid foundation. Hallelujah. And it doesn't matter what others say and what others believe is, we know that we are standing on solid foundation. Can you praise God, somebody? What are the three things that happen in the portion of scripture read? Number one, Elijah fled to Beersheba at the threat of Jezebel to preserve his life. The text commences by saying, and Ahab told Jezebel all that Elijah had done, and withal how he had slain the prophets with the edge of the sword, and Jezebel became mad. Jezebel said, I am going to make your life as one of those whom you have slain. And Elijah, having heard that, human feeling got the better of him, human emotion, and he ran to Beersheba, found a juniper tree, bowed himself under there and said, God, it is enough. I have had enough and I'm not prepared for any more. I am not better than my fathers who have been slain. Take my life before Jezebel takes it. But God had other plans. Touch your neighbor and tell them, God has other plans for you. I don't care what you have contemplated. Come on, somebody. A speaker at the men's prayer breakfast yesterday morning, amen, spoke to me in an out-of-session discussion. And he said, Bishop Davis, there is not a day in my office that we do not counsel persons who were contemplating suicide. He said, the devil has been reaping havoc in this land. But I'm here to tell you, it doesn't matter what you have contemplated. It doesn't matter where you are right now. God has greater plans for you. Come on, somebody. Touch your neighbor and tell them, that is for you. Whether you've been to school, never been to school, literate, illiterate, rich, poor, up, down, high, low, short, stout, skinny, fat, white, black, pink, yellow, loved, hated, it doesn't matter who you are. There is someone who has you on his agenda. And you are not at the bottom of God's agenda. You are at the top of God's agenda. You do not take the place of any other business. So when meeting is closed, we deal with that. No, you are central to God's master plan. Lift your hand and say, I am central to God's master plan. You see, I got to get some of you to understand this. Because you see, the devil has been whispering all kinds of stuff in your ears. And it is getting in your spirit. To the point where some of you who were once loyal, faithful, committed Christians have now begun to drag your feet, pulling behind, falling afar off, merely going through the motion. I want to let you know that God has you on his agenda and he has great plans for you. Elijah said, it's time to die. God said, who tell you that? You better get ready to live and to work and to war against the devil and bring down principality. Touch that neighbor sitting beside you and tell the neighbor, get ready to work, get ready to war, get ready to rumble, get ready to roll, get ready to show the devil that you're not going to give him. Oh, some of you are not saying anything. Well, if you want to stay under the pressure, the devil will intensify the pressure. You got to rock yourself and roll yourself and shake yourself and say, this is not where I belong, although it feels lonely.
I got somebody in my corner.
Oh, I would to God some of you would praise him down there. Woo! I can't take to see good Christians who have mastered the heart of serving God and defeating the devil over many years, crossed many hot burning desert, found the right way, the good old path, and now we are almost at the bend to enter heaven's portal, and this is a time when some begin to get lackadaisical and weak and discouraged and faithless and doubtful. Brother, sister, you better know who you are. Touch your neighbor and tell them, if you are an Elijah, I am your angel. Oh, you're not with me, you're not with me. Come on, there's an angel sitting beside you. If you are an Elijah, you have an angel beside you. And an angel going to talk in your ears, talk in your life, talk in your soul, and say, get up, Elijah. What are you doing here? Tell them again, I am your angel. I am your angel. I'm going to talk to you. I'm going to speak in your life. Come on, angel, tell Elijah something. Come on, angel, tell your Elijah something. Oh my God, where is the church? Tell your Elijah something. Talk to your Elijah. Tell your Elijah something. And I say nothing. Woo! All right. He fled to Beersheba at the threat of Jezebel, number one, to preserve his life. Number two, he was touched and comforted by an angel while he was there. I hope you still have your angel beside you. Number three, God sends him to anoint an earthly trinity. God said there are three persons who you must go anoint. Anoint Azazel. Anoint Jehu and anoint Elisha, because here you are sitting down having pity party. God, you don't see what me going through. Listen to me, God is never moved by anybody's pity party. God is moved by your faith. Come on, somebody. So while he was there pity partying and sobbing and crying and all kinds of stuff, God said, that's not my cup of tea. Get up and do what is to be done. God, can I preach to somebody here? They're sobbing and crying. Lord, look what I'm going through. God, my back is against the wall. That ain't going to help you, honey. That's just going to destroy you more. It is not important what comes your way. It's how you deal with it. It's how you handle it. It's what you do with it. Talk to me here, somebody. Hallelujah. The same water that preserve or cause some people to preserve life is the same water that takes other people's lives, because some went under and stayed under, while others learn to swim right in the midst of the danger. Oh, you're not talking with me here. Even if you can't swim and you get in the ocean and you find danger hit you, try a thing. Shake your hand, move your feet, rock your head, miracles still perform. Don't just lay down and dead. Come on, church. Don't just lay down and die. Somebody wave your hands and praise God. Touch your neighbor, tell them, do something, man, do something. Even if you can't do it, try a thing. God is a God of miracle.
Hallelujah. Even if you can't do it, you have no heart, you have no skill. You've never been taught, but do a thing. Come on, come on. When trouble hits you, try and put on picnic clothes. Even picnic shirt will fit you. Try and draw on something. Not can I preach you, don't stay there naked. Draw on something. Miracles still work. Lift your hand and say, miracles still work. Miracles still happen. Check it, Thomas. Boy, I feel like preaching here. Jesus Christ the same. Yesterday, today, and forever. What doest thou there? Woo! Sometimes it feels lonely. I know. Loneliness and leadership are synonymous. They're almost inseparable. But sometimes the devil uses all of that to stop the plan of God. But I have an angel. Do you have an angel? Yes. Sometimes it feels lonely, but you're not alone. Keep on keeping on. Glory to God. The sun will shine again. Quiet, team. All right. Oh, no. That's too deep for this moment. Oh, no. That's deep stuff. Let's leave that one for now. Elijah declared three things, or three sins committed by the children of Israel, that he told God, God, I can't deal with them people here no more. And he said it on two occasions. He said, look at what they have done. They have forsaken your covenant, thrown down your altars, and slew your prophets with the sword. God, you don't see what's happening? I feel lonely. Talk to me here, somebody. Oh, Lord Jesus. Those of us who are holiness preachers and holiness believers, it almost feels lonely. Can I say that again? We almost feel lonely. When you're talking about presenting your bodies as living sacrifice, some church folks say, what you're talking about? When you talk about sanctification, holiness, they are in church too, and they are foreigners and strangers to them kind of thing. Holiness believers are under threat these days. Oh, you're not with me? We're under threat with the New Age kind of religion. We're under threat with the wholesale reduction of price that's going on out there. The price is being highly or greatly reduced. No longer any man come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross and follow me. Come on, somebody. It is, if it feels good, do it. If it pleases you, do it. If it doesn't affect your conscience, do it. You know, there's a counselor that comes on the radio. I almost want to call his name, but let me leave him nameless. I preached here some times ago and made the mistake of calling an high official name. And I happened to have met him in the airport the other day in New York. And he looked at me and said, Pastor, I heard that you preach in your church calling my name. Oh, you're not with me here. So, whilst you should carry the gospel, some of you carry the wrong thing.
So let me not. And it was not malicious that I called the person's name. Of course, he said it jovially and very nice. But let's leave that out. There is a counselor that comes on radio, and I appreciate him very much. Because you know why? Among other things, he said to people from time to time, whatever is the teaching of your church, so long as you are a member of the church, you should abide by the teaching. If it reaches a point where you no longer concur, you no longer believe that kind of teaching, he said you have a choice. But as long as you are there, you should abide by the teaching. That's good counseling, or you're not with me. Somebody praise God down there. Hallelujah. So we are under threat because things have been reduced to each man should do it as he sees it. Are you not with me? And these days anything goes. It's no big thing to be in the church and have all kinds of lifestyle. But any man who is in Christ, I love the book, you know. Come on, somebody. Any man in Christ is a new creature. All things are passed away. And behold, all things. And there are some kinds of lifestyle that you cannot embrace and at the same time being a practicing Christian. Can't work. Are you not with me here? Come on, somebody. You can't be a drug user and a drug pusher and at the same time be a practicing Christian. Come on, somebody. You cannot be a homosexual or a lesbian and at the same time say you're a practicing Christian. You're not saying much amen on that. Come on, somebody. And the list is an endless one. Sorry to have named two. But certain things you just cannot do. You cannot be and hope you're a worker and at the same time say you're a practicing Christian. You can't be an adulterer and say at the same time you're a practicing Christian. You cannot be a fornicator, living in fornication, and at the same time you're a practicing Christian. Come on, angel, help me preach this gospel. Tell Elijah it don't work, it don't work. Tell Elijah it don't work, it don't work. Woo! Somebody praise God down there. Try and get into this. God said to Elijah, I heard you. I heard what you have said concerning Jezebel's threats and what you have said concerning the children of Israel and what you have said concerning yourself. I am the only one who is left, and I'm about gone because they'll soon kill me. Come on, somebody. God says in verse 11, go up to the mountain. Go before me. And I'm going to manifest another trinity before you, Elijah. Go up there. And when Elijah stood on the mount before God, a great, strong, mighty wind ripped through the mountain. But God was not in the wind. An earthquake came, but God was not in the earthquake. Then a fire came. God was not in the fire. Come, oh glory to God. Talk with me, somebody. And this kind of fire, when you're dealing with this kind of fire, you need a fourth man. Come on, somebody. You need a fourth man to step on in. But after the wind and the earthquake and the fire, Elijah heard something. Lean on somebody and see if you hear anything. God Almighty. Elijah heard something. It wasn't the renting of the mountain and the rocks,
with wind or earthquake or fire, but he heard a still small voice. No wonder somebody said his voice makes a difference. When he speaks, he relieves my troubles. Oh, hallelujah! There's no other voice like the voice of Jesus. He whispers sweet peace to me. When I am cast down in body, in spirit, in soul, he whispers. Oh, God Almighty. Come on, angel. Whisper in Elijah's ear and tell Elijah you are not alone. Tell Elijah you're not alone. I know you feel lonely. I know you feel threatened. I know your back is against the wall. I know all hell is against you. I know they criticize you. I know they backbite you. I know they tear you down. I know they want to destroy you. I know they set up derrick for you. I know they dig ditches for you. I know they want to kill you. But you're not alone. Somebody's in your corner. My God Almighty. The wind don't reveal him. The earthquake don't reveal him. The fire don't reveal him. But sit on where you are. Hold your seat in Zion. You are going to hear the still small voice. Somebody praise God down here. Do we have any Elijah down here? Do we have any angel down here? Come on, angel, tell Elijah you are not alone. God is on your side. David said, God is my refuge and strength, my very present help in the time of trouble. Therefore will we not fear, though the earth be removed and carried in the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, and the mountains shake with the swelling thereof. There is a river, the stream where shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. Lift your hand and say, God is. Say, God is. God is. Tell me who he is. Tell me what he is. He's my refuge. He's my strength. He's my bread. He's my water. He's my pillar of cloud by day. My pillar of fire by night. He's my conquering lion of the tribe of Judah. He is my rock in a weary land. He is my shelter in the time of storm. God is. God is. God is my all in all. Clap your hands and shout the highest praise. My God. Woo. Dear Jesus. God is. Don't let ghosts fool you. God is. Don't let situation hold you down. God is. Don't let demon discourage you. God is. God, can I preach here? Don't let poverty threaten you. God is. Don't let loneliness hold you down. God is. Don't let hypocrites stand in your way. God is. It feels lonely, but you're not alone. Somebody's in your corner. God, I feel the Holy Ghost in this church. Nobody feel what I feel. I feel like running. Amamama shatabaha.
Sit down, please. Give me a few more minutes. My God of heaven, the Holy Ghost is in the house. Either by an angel, by the word, or by a special voice. But he was visited. Lift your hand and say, visit me, Jesus. And one among the Trinity said to him, arise and heat, for the journey's too great for thee. What doest thou here, Elijah? What you doing here, sir? Do you know where you have come from to reach here? God, can I preach for five more? Point your hand and say, bless the preacher, Jesus. Thank you for that prayer. Elijah! Do you know how much you have regressed? Can I simplify this? Do you know how many backward steps or downward steps you have made in order to reach in this position? Preach to me, man. You are coming from the mountain of God, where you saw miracles. You saw the fire of God fell and lick up 12 barrels of water, burn up stone and burn up wood. Do you know how high you are coming from, Elijah? And do you now know how low you have reached? Elijah, some of you are coming from 5 days and 7 days and 9 days and many days of fasting and prayer.
Some of you are coming from very special set apart consecration service. You know how high you're coming from. You want to preach here, you know. You want to preach. Hold on, man. Hold on. Take your time. Elijah. Look which part today. Look where you sit down now. Take a mental flight and look which part you're in there. Excuse me, please. Look where you were. Look at the things you saw happen when you were there. Boy, if I'm not preaching here, I don't know who is preaching. Maybe you are preaching. Do you remember when you, Elijah, challenged Ahab on the same Jezebel and said, gather me, everybody, to Mount Carmel. You one took on 450 false prophets. And you never knew discouragement nor weakness. Look where you were. You had special prayer time, special Bible reading time, special devotion time. You're never too tired. You'd rather be late for an engagement than to miss your devotion time. Look where you were. Look where you were, Elijah. Before pride and self come in. And now you see yourself. Lord, we can't manage this. Jezebel, I will kill me. You who challenged not only Jezebel, but Ahab and Jezebel, and tell Obadiah, go tell him I am in town. Come meet me. Leave me, let me preach, man. God tell me, preach to you. Look where you were, Elijah. You don't remember where you were. And look which part you reach now. Under juniper tree, boy, you won't die. When you were fired up, you took on lion and tiger and bear. When you were fired up, you are in the Sunday school class before the students reach there. When you were fired up, you were in the rehearsal room before the choir directors reached there. When you were fired up, you were here before any prayer mother reached here. But now we almost have to beg you to come, beg you to participate, beg you to lead a song, because you are now doing God a favor. Elijah. Shalamaku City. Elijah. Those are for the discouraged Elijahs. But for the faithful Elijahs, it feels lonely. When three men turn up for men's prayer meeting, it feels lonely. When half a dozen choir members turn up for choir rehearsal, it feels lonely. When you can't find a musician weeknights to keep music ministry going, it feels lonely. When you can't find a Simon Peter to watch with you that extra hour, it feels lonely. Man of God, woman of God. But you're not alone. You're not alone. God says, verses 15 and 16, I'm getting ready to close. But before I close, many of you should be at the altar, and you know it too. God said, Elijah,
You go now and mantle the earthly trinity. I'm going to orchestrate a plan of action. God said, go anoint Hazael. Go anoint Jehu. Go anoint Elisha. No, you feel lonely, but you have to do what must be done. You have to do what must be done. Oh, the Holy Ghost has dropped this in my heart. Faithful givers, faithful tithers, it feels lonely because other people have to buy the food first and buy the this and buy the that and buy all what they don't need. And if anything is left over, they say, Lord, here is the leftover. Faithful tithers who make sure you write that check the first thing you do and you separate God's portion the first thing you do. It's not a big crowd, it's a lonely group. It feels lonely. It feels lonely. Come on, somebody. But you're not alone. Dear God Almighty, I have to preach these kind of messages. God said in verse 17, I'm going to deploy the anointed resources. Anoint Jehu. Anoint Hazael. And anoint Elisha. I am going to deploy the anointed resources. All right, man. You wait when God get ready to deploy and to set up people. You think he's just going to set up any and everybody? God told me to tell you, he's about to deploy the anointed resources. He's about to do that. He's going to place them in strategic position, and every post will be manned. Every position will be filled. Thus saith the Holy Ghost. Because God is going to deploy the anointed resources. I feel like preaching. I'm closing. Set up Hazael at one corner. Set up Jehu at another corner. Set up Elisha in another corner. And those who escape the sword of this one shall fall in the sword of the other. And those who escape the sword of the other shall fall in the hand of the sword of the other. But God said, I have this thing worked out. Lift your hand and say, God has it all worked out. Or some of you are not saying anything. God has his church all worked out. Woo! And when God sent him to anoint those earthly trinity. Hallelujah. 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 I feel the glory of God upon this place. It feels lonely, but you are not alone. Lift your hand and say, lonely, but not alone. Not alone. Intercessors. Intercessors. It feels lonely. Those who have to burn the midnight oil and burn the more early morning oil. Intercessors. It feels lonely. But you are not alone. Prayer workers. It feels lonely. But you are not alone. Listen this, young people. Moral, sober, godly young people, it feels lonely. Lonely in high school. Lonely in primary school. Lonely in colleges and universities.
moral, sober, godly young people and know it feels lonely. But you are not alone. Not alone. Rakashe morosa kabio. Rama sekete. Finally, God said, I have me. I have an army, Elijah. Elijah, I don't know what 7,000 meant in those days, but 7,000 then might be like a trillion today. Oh, you're not hearing me. God said, I have me. 7,000, all the knees that have not bowed to Baal, on all the lips that have not kissed him. It's not every young person going around kissing and feeling and petting and sexing. God said, I have me some. I have some. They are lonely, but they are not alone. Stand with me, everybody who's seated, please. Those who in the audience, everybody have to do something. You know, I don't know what you're going to do. You can't just sit down there. So you have to do something, man. Do something or say something. Alabakoshetoromasata. 7,000 Rokoto Mushia. Everybody pray. Lift up your hands and pray, everybody. Come on. Holy Ghost, Pentecostal prayer. Pray and shake the place. Pray and rock it. Pray and let it vibrate. Ataloki Masie. La kritama sata rako moshetie ru hallelujah. It feels lonely as a holiness preacher. It gets lonely sometimes, but I know I'm not alone. Across the length and breadth of Jamaica, every nook and cranny, there are men of God. There are women of God crying out to God. Spare thy people, O God. Save the nation. Hallelujah. 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 Almighty, nobody not saying anything or doing anything. You must be visited by word, wind, or voice. Word, angel, or voice. Lord, take me back to the place where. It's been so hard trying to make it on my own. Lord, I need your direction just to make the right selection.
lift up your hands and call in the name of Jesus Christ. Everybody that has breath, is there one without breath? Well, let everything that have breath. Hallelujah! Praise God until you feel it in your soul. It feels lonely, but you're not alone. I must touch your sister. Yes, in the name of Jesus. Yes, 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 yes. Holy Ghost of God, anoint. It feels lonely, lonely, but God tell me to tell you, you're not alone. Fight the good fight of fear. Fight, 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 fight. Anointed men and women are around you. Anointed men and women are around you. Anointed people are praying for you. You're not alone. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm not my home. I belong to Jesus. Stand on your feet, everybody. We are going to sing it back. And I want to pray over you. I want to pray over everybody standing. Hallelujah. Take me back.